The man-made machine is no doubt an attraction of sorts, and when it lands anywhere, excited members of the public rush to literally land with it. Never mind the dogs and chicken that would be scampering for safety at the same time. It is no longer the preserve of a few. It is trendy. It is time-saving. It is convenient. It is comfortable. It is a crowd puller. It puts the mheshimiwa in his or her own class. But a dusty landing like this one can also land the mheshimiwa in trouble. Some of the politicians who are known to own helicopters are Mathira MP Ephraim Maina, Juja MP William Kabogo, Deputy Prime Minister Uhuru Kenyatta, former President Daniel Arap Moi and his son Gideon, former Minister Simeon Nyachae, and presidential aspirant and Gatanga MP Peter Kenneth. Former Keio South MP Nicholas Biwot has just acquired one. Colonel Paul Ndenge of the aircraft leasing services based at the Wilson Airport in Nairobi says a brand new five-seater helicopter costs about 250 million shillings.
The main two types of helicopters that are operated around in Kenya are Bell helicopters from the US and Eurocopter, the one which is right behind us.
A second-hand chopper is cheaper. The price varies depending on the manufacturer and the year it was manufactured. Bell helicopters are cheaper than Eurocopters. To operate an aircraft, one must be in possession of an air operator's certificate. Individual owners who do not have the certificate end up leasing the aircraft to licensed companies.
We charter for them to other people. When they want to use it, they use it. When we charter out, we get some percentage, just a little bit, I mean about 10% out of for every hour we fly.
Some of the politicians who frequently hire choppers include Prime Minister Raila Odinga, Deputy Prime Minister Musalia Mudavadi, Eldoret North MP William Ruto, Vice President Kalonzo Musyoka, and Internal Security Minister Professor George Saitoti.
The rate varies from, especially ad hoc, varies from between $1,700 to $2,200 per hour.
That translates to about 150,000 shillings to 200,000 shillings per flight hour. With a minimum charge on hours, some companies may ask for 3 hours, others 2 hours.
When you fly to Kisii and back, that is 2 hours, 1 hour to Kisii and another hour coming back.
Meaning even for ordinary Kenyans, you can share the cost. For instance, five people going for a weekend trip to Kisii and back could each pay 80,000 shillings.
Ad hoc charter, I'm talking about politicians, I'm talking of businessmen, tourists, and government ministry. Those are the ones who come in ad hoc and they come and charter the aircraft. Now, the other type is long-term contract, which is multinational companies, and they normally come in for oil exploration, map and survey. Those are some of the things they come and do.
During campaigns, politicians are able to address several rallies in a day, hopping from place to place, overcoming the challenges that come with road transport, especially in remote areas. The longest flight from Nairobi is to Mandera, where one takes 2 hours to arrive in Wajir, fuel the aircraft, and fly for another 1.5 hours to Mandera, meaning you need a total of about 7 flight hours.
Majority of them want helicopters to hire to Meru side and Kisii side, and I do believe that is where there is a swing vote.
Apart from ALS, other companies that offer similar services include Lady Lorry, Air Kenya, Everett Aviation, Seacham, Abadeas, Evergreen, and Kenya Wildlife Services. KWS has one helicopter and one caravan, that is a fixed-wing aircraft for commercial purposes. Choppers are more popular because they can land almost anywhere, while a fixed-wing aircraft requires an airstrip to land.
Especially this year, we expect the clans to be more of politicians, especially ad hoc, for ad hoc charter.
Some institutions have their own choppers. For instance, Kenya Power, Kenya Pipeline and the police, which are not used for commercial purposes. Now, there is a cost implication for the taxpayer because for government officials or public institutions using choppers to fly to functions, that cost is partly borne by you. And that cost is justifiable if it's incurred in the course of providing services to the nation. But questionable and wasteful when politicians turn public functions into campaign forums after hiring choppers using your hard-earned money. Alex Chamwada for Citizen TV.